Today, we're excited to teach you a little bit about how SDS is used to run protein gels.
Sodium dodecyl sulfate, or simply SDS, is a strong detergent that has a long hydrophobic tail and a polar head that carries a negative charge. SDS is an amphiphilic molecule that has both hydrophilic and hydrophobic properties. When SDS is present in aqueous solution at a high enough concentration, spherical structures will start to form so that the hydrophobic tails are buried on the inside, and the charged hydrophilic head can interact with the water molecules. We call these spherical structures micelles, which are thermodynamically favorable in aqueous solutions. SDS is a strong detergent that is used in the lab for several purposes, such as breaking up cell membranes and denaturing proteins. In this video, we will explain what SDS does to a protein sample and why it's used in SDS-PAGE.
SDS-PAGE makes use of a polyacrylamide gel, which is a sieve-like matrix that we use to separate molecules of different sizes. Smaller molecules can fit more easily through the pores in the gel and will travel faster compared to larger molecules, which will have greater difficulty moving through the gel. An electric field will be applied to this gel, which allows molecules that have a net charge to move towards one electrode according to their net charge. Remember that molecules with a larger net charge will move more quickly as well. The goal is to separate the proteins in our sample based on their difference in mass and only their masses. However, to do this, there are a couple of challenges we have to overcome.
First, we need to correct for differences in charge. Different proteins will have different amino acid compositions, which leads to different net charges that are neutral, positive, or negative. This means that if we apply an electrical field, some will migrate to the positive anode, and others will move to the negative cathode, which makes it very difficult to order proteins according to molecular weight and interpret the results.
Second, we need to make sure we order according to mass and only mass. Consider, for example, two proteins of different masses that, because of the way they are folded, have similar volumes. They will migrate through the pores at equal speed and won't be separated, despite their differences in molecular mass.
On the other hand, if we had two different proteins of identical mass, of which one has a more net negative charge because of its amino acid composition, then this one will be more strongly attracted to the positive anode. Since this protein is more strongly attracted to the positive anode, this protein will move faster towards it. This protein with a larger negative charge will end up lower in the gel than one with a smaller net negative charge. This is true even though the two proteins have the same mass.
The solution? SDS, a strong anionic detergent that performs two actions on the proteins in the mix. One, it breaks up protein structure and unfolds the proteins. Two, it coats proteins with a negative charge proportional to their mass. Let's talk about the first action, unfolding the protein. When added to a solution of proteins, the hydrophobic tail of SDS will interact with the hydrophobic nonpolar regions of the protein, while the polar and negatively charged sulfate group will interact with surrounding water molecules. This causes the protein to unravel and denature, as it disrupts the non-covalent interactions that held the protein in its folded position.
Now let's take a look at the second action, which is that SDS coats the protein with a negative charge. Remember that each SDS molecule has a negative charge at its polar head. Thus, any protein coated with SDS gains a strong net negative charge, canceling out any net positive charges. Moreover, approximately one SDS molecule binds to every two amino acids in a protein. So the net negative charge will be proportional to the number of amino acids of the fragment, and thus its molecular mass. The result of all of this is that we can separate the different protein fragments based on their mass alone.